Assalamu alaikum. I'm your teacher, and today the topic I'm going to explain you is classification of living things. Classification means grouping of living things into groups which are similar to each other. For example, plants will be kept with plants and animals will be kept in a group with animals. We can't place animals with plants because they are not similar to each other. Living things can be grouped into five main groups called kingdoms: plants, animals, fungi, protista, and monera. First, we will discuss monera. Monera means bacteria. The monerans are unicellular organisms. Unicellular means that all bacteria consist of only one cell. They are single-celled organisms. They lack nuclear membrane. Now, what does this mean, that they lack nuclear membrane? For example, we are living in a house and our house has walls around them. So like monera have nucleus without walls. They do not have walls around them. We can compare membrane to a wall here. Protists. Protists are eukaryotic organisms. They have a membrane bound nucleus. Membrane bound nucleus means that the nucleus of protists have a wall around them. They have a proper membrane around their nucleus, unlike monera. Eukaryotic organisms have membrane bound nucleus, while prokaryotic animals like monera do not have membrane bound nucleus. They are also unicellular. Protists are also unicellular, but some protists are multicellular as well. Multicellular means more than one cell. So the main difference between the protists and the monera is that monera have no nuclear membrane bound nucleus, while protists have a membrane bound nucleus. Otherwise, both are unicellular, so we can't differentiate between them. Bacteria. As you can see in the diagram, bacterial cell did not consist any nuclear bound nucleus. While in the diagram of protist, you can see a nuclear bound nucleus at point number 2. So this is the main difference between a bacteria and a protist. Now, what is the difference between a bacteria and a virus? Living organisms, bacteria are living organisms, unicellular, like single cell, they have one cell. On the other hand, viruses are not living and they have no cells. They are acellular. Acellular means having no cells. Bacteria are larger than viruses. They are about 1000 nanometers. Viruses are smaller as compared to bacteria. They are 220 to 300 nanometers. In Latin, bacteria means little sticks, while viruses means poison. Bacterial diseases can be treated with antibiotics. Viral diseases cannot be treated with antibiotics. Like for example, COVID-19 cannot be treated with any antibiotic. Now look at the diagram of the virus. DNA is present inside the head of the virus. The most important thing in the virus is its DNA, because through its DNA it replicates itself. Replication means it reproduces itself. New viruses are made through this DNA. It consists of a head, a neck, collar, sheath, tail fiber, and a base plate. Now let's see how a virus works. Virus enters the human body and it releases its RNA. Some viruses consist of RNA, while other viruses consist of DNA. Then in the second step, the RNA takes over the nucleus of the cell. Virus attacks the nucleus of the cell. Then in third steps, RNA reproduces in order to invade the new cells. The RNA inside the nucleus started replicating itself to make new viruses so that they can attack new cells of the body. In the fourth step, new viral particles releases and destroy the cell. The new viral particles which are made, they destroy the cell and releases from the cell so that they can invade other cells. Viruses replicate very fastly. Like one virus replicates into 2 into 4, 4 into 6. And that's how a virus works. Now this is, thank you so much. This is all for today.